Hey guys, what's up? Master1703 here with the other game that came out on January 24th. Kingdom Hearts 2.8 Final Chapter Prologue. And with that, we will be playing Kingdom Hearts 0.2 Birth by Sleep, A Fragment Passage. So, if you follow me on Twitter, you know I beat Proud Mode last night. Which, in this game, when you beat Proud Mode, you unlock Critical Mode. And I believe in the other games before this, it's already unlocked. So, I thought it wasn't too long. It took me about 5 hours to beat it on Proud Mode. So, I thought maybe, why not play it Critical Mode, do an actual playthrough. Mic fell. So I thought, yeah, why not do a playthrough? I know I'm not going to say it's going to be as easy as Proud Mode or the other difficulties, but there's also like, there's also like more stuff that I can get on my second playthrough. So, when the actual intro song comes, I'm gonna skip it. I'm just gonna post a link to, I'm gonna have it posted in like a separate video. So, I have a link to that. So, I believe the song, like, stops. I've heard like the song, people get strikes. And I don't want to do that.
The great battle with Xehanort is almost upon us.
I probably will do a game drop distance playthrough also. I'm not sure when. I'm playing it for fun.
We must hasten to assemble the seven guardians.
I'll figure that out.
It is time to return to our world.
Like I was talking about with the intro. I'm going to post that probably on my... I'll make another channel just for, so I can put it there.
Must be saved,
and also
from their
put the
sad end, for
Unchained
they have
Key video on there
to achieve. Following their first battle with Xehanort, Ventus's heart refused to awaken, and so Aqua found a safe location to conceal him. But when she set off in search of her other missing friend, Terra, she fell to a place from which there is no return without outside help.
I saw her in the realm of darkness.
This is the part I'm gonna skip. I want to make a bit of a joke, but it's kind of spoiler. So, how does Mickey know the stuff that he wasn't there for? Because you start off without Mickey on your team. Aqua's like by herself right now. How does he know this part happened?
Oh, could it be?
Like, that's just me. But what was I gonna say? Yeah, I'm gonna post the intro, which it's pretty cool the way they remixed Simple and Clean. And also the Unchained Key, the whole video, on that other account. So I just transferred over my character from... Let me just get rid of these. I don't like the flashing new video. My character from... my Proud Mode playthrough, so that she's dressed in like the customization, and I have most of the objectives done. So it says there are new ones. Okay, so defeat the tower. Wait, defeat the demon tower with Spellweaver. Finish. Okay. Open all the treasure chests. And find lingering memories. So this is the first section, the castle town. So let's I think the lingering memories is when she, like, when you actually unlock some of her abilities. Because I don't want to say too much, but when you, when like a flashback happens, you actually unlock a, like, you double jump and stuff like that, I believe.
Why is Cinderella's world here in the darkness?
I'm actually curious about that too. I've only played Kingdom Hearts 1, which I I haven't finished. When I originally played it on the PS2, me and my brothers couldn't figure out how to get to Agrabah. And when I got it for the PS3, I realized that we didn't. There was a scene we missed, and it was the warp zone to the the next section of worlds. So we didn't realize that.
There's no time in the realm of darkness.
And me and my brothers, I haven't like fully played two, but we played it together, and one of my brothers beat it.
In the realm of light, do days or years pass with each step? I know something has started to go wrong.
So of the main games,
I must hurry.
I haven't like myself beaten. So like the side quests or the side story games, I've beaten Chain of Memories on the Game Boy Advance. I didn't know about Birth by Sleep until like the PSP era was kind of done. Actually, until like 2012, honestly. I saw a YouTuber.
I guess I know which way I'm going.
Play it. So I know a bit of the story there. Recoded. I didn't have a DS. What other ones? Doom Drop Distance. I'm playing it with this. During my free time. I didn't play the 3DS version.
I haven't felt my heart.
Whenever I look for a copy, it's either
a long time,
like expensive, or it's sold out at GameStop. So, place. And I am actually playing Kingdom Hearts Key on my
phone. Like worse things are stirring.
Oh, there's also 365, the one with Roxy. I had an emulator, and I played a bit of it. So I, for the most part, kind of understand it. I've also watched, like, this was a while back, a lot of lore videos, like, oh, let's try and piece together the story. So, I'm not as caught up as I used to be, but I kind of understand it. When I played, my first playthrough with this, I watched, I had the Aqua story playing in the background, so I remember some of it from the original Birth by Sleep.
I thought I had nothing in life to lose.
So I'm actually curious on why Cinderella's world is in the realm of darkness. I don't really remember. I know they do explain it, like, a lot of worlds have fallen. So this is what I was talking about with a flashback. It's from Birth by Sleep. Cinderella, who was like the villain of it? It was the stepmother and the stepsisters. Those were like the really villains of that. So in Birth by Sleep,
here too,
they summoned
everyone in this world thought that they were safe
because of the darkness in their heart.
Not just the people.
I guess
the dog waiting for his owner.
What happened?
The cat curled up in her nook. So much life. Trees and flowers. There's no deeper sadness than discovering all that you knew was gone. The grief in this place is too much to fathom.
I would understand Snow White. Because, no, not Snow White. Sleeping Beauty, because you have the Wicked Witch.
That's enough.
I mean, not Wicked
I can't
Witch.
Keep on wishing for the past.
Which... That's what I would think. Would cause this. But... Radiant... No, not Radiant Gardens. What's her level?
Yep. Yep.
I can't go back. I thought that was. But Maleficent's world. I would have thought. Yeah, I would understand. That would be in the realm of darkness, because Maleficent's. From what I remember. The main one that gets like the main Disney villain that's like that gathers others besides like organization 13 and all that. I would think her world, if anything, would be in the realm of darkness, but I am not 100% caught up with everything. Like, that was just, that's just me, kind of talking. So there are 9 chests.
The rogue collapsed when the clock advanced.
I wonder if that includes the Zodiac chest.
If only I made it in time. But there is no time in this place, only the clock.
That sounds like a riddle. There's no... She's in a place where there's no time, and the only representation of time is a clock that is frozen in time, that yet advances in time. But when you hit the gears, it goes back an hour. That's a little confusing. And it... Oh, not only that. Not only does it go back an hour, it reverses time. In a place that time doesn't exist. Or there's no...
I knew it.
Oh, what is it? What's the word I'm looking for? In a place where time is not defined, pretty much. So...
I should look for a gear.
Actually, the phrase I'm looking for is a place outside of time.
Okay.
I guess that's the best way to describe this.
Yep.
Understand why that was maybe because it wouldn't have affected either way. I was gonna say the reason why I did that is so I can recharge my magic points, but I forgot there's a save point right there.
Yep.
She does that for me.
Okay. Hey, farewell.
So, of the original objectives, I've done all except getting to level 70 and 80, I believe that's what the last one was. and the Shatter one. So that one, I have to freeze 5 enemies, and I cannot unlock them. Freeze 5 enemies and shatter them. I think it's 5 at once. That's, like, those were the only ones from the original objectives I did not do. So here's get to level 70. I'm guessing that's either level 80 or 99. I'm not sure. Since it's going by 10, I'm guessing 80. An icebreaker. Freeze 5 heartless and shatter 5 of them. So my idea is doing find lingering memories, open all chests. Okay, so these are pretty much the same. When I played the third Aqua, she caused a lot of problems. So
is that that's gonna be... the bridge?
That's not giving XP. I mean, health. Man, did they take that away on vertical mode?
Yep.
There's gonna be a. If that's true, there's gonna be a lot of going to save points just to. Heal up. And also, in proud mode, my most used skill was cure with 104 times. Yeah, that's gonna definitely go on, especially with the bosses. Yeah, bosses, because you play that Aqua against the Phantom Aqua. I was gonna say boss because like you pretty much fight the same thing several times. Oh, the one in the forest also, I guess that could count. So I guess like technically three. So the way I kind of want to play this with my magic is I want to hold off on using cure because that takes all your magic until like last minute. So that'll be like the last spell I cast, unless I have to cast it like then and there. So if it's like the start of a fight and I get hit for 99% of my health, and I know I'm gonna get hit again, I'll use cure. If I know I'll be able to survive, I'll deal without it. So we got our focus meter.
I think that might be a gear up on that roof. Yep.
Gotcha. I at least got the one that said, hit off or hits excellent 16, but not 16 times. 6 times in a row. I'm trying to make it sound like I'm better than I actually am. Let's head to that next gear. Yeah, they did take away.
Yep.
At least when I played through proud mode, whenever you destroyed an object, you got focus, you got health and all that. Oh, that's gonna be bad for the final boss. I really relied on that. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's where lingering memory is. The glass slipper. I thought it was those flashbacks. So in each level there's gonna be something. So this was Cinderella, there's gonna be one for Sleeping Beauty. And maybe from Kingdom Hearts 1? Because I'm trying to think what the levels were there. It's not like, oh, the a lot of world. This is the shortest game. Like I said, I beat him 5 hours on proud mode, and most of the time was struggling with like the boss, especially that final boss. So maybe in the like next world there'll be something. I think that's box number chest number 3. Wardrobe. Back, let's see what. Ooh. That looks nice. But I'll stick with these. Actually. Yeah. Let's keep the flawless. So let's see. Dark World is what the whole thing. Forest of Thorns. The World Within, that's Snow White. Forest of Thorns. I think that might be Sleeping Beauty. So I think there are 3. No. I think that might still be Snow White. I'm not too sure. Alright, let's check the chest. Okay, so. Oh, that's actually 4. Oh, yeah, the map. So we need 5 more chests. I believe I know where they are. All except for the floating chest. Enough. Which I'm not entirely sure. 100% sure if it counts or not. But it is a chest. There is a chest. There's a chest that counts. Oh, even the enemies don't drop health. That means Kirog is definitely gonna.
I've got to remember to check around the tower.
That's gonna be my main like spell. Okay. Let me regen some of this magic. Just there. Let him cool down. Oh.
Yep.
Nope. So I'm definitely gonna have to take advantage of like elemental attacks because Ares. So apparently those, from what I've heard, elemental attacks actually do more damage. So that was fire. I use ice. When I fight a water one, I use thunder. And I'm guessing ground is fire. I don't know. You can't fight too many of those. Alright, so midair dash.
Yep.
Okay, so there's the area that I'm going to. No. Okay, good.
I can see the whole square from here.
Oh, that's one area. I want to go up here first.
Yeah.
That's where the last gear is. But before that, I want to get this chest up here. Ah!
Yep.
Keep pressing square instead of circle. Or jump.
Yep.
Okay. one chest.
Yep.
I don't know why I keep pressing square to jump. I understand pressing X to jump because I do that in Destiny. Also, if you're playing around, this is where you get the meteor shower objective and top of tower objective. Alright, so where am I at? I think that should have been 8. Oh, 7. Okay, so there's one near that gear.
Yep.
I guess that's how I'll end it off. I'll look for that last. I'll kind of want it to be like, the way I want this to be sectioned off is maybe clear the world, then a boss on its own. Because, like I said, it's critical mode and I'm not like the best at Kingdom Hearts. I'll admit it. But, so the might be the way I set it up is there'll be what's called a whole episode on a boss, and actually depending on how fast the boss goes, maybe the start of the next area. So at least 2 parts for an area, so that's including boss fights. So this will be part one, the next boss, or the next part will be the boss part, that'll be part two of this, like this. Let's find that last chest.
Yep.
Unless it's something to get after the boss. But I doubt it.
Yep.
So that's where we had the first one. Excuse me, the first gear, so. We haven't really explored over there, but that's past that save point in that, like, right next to that arch area over there where Aqua's hit is, that's where the boss is. So I need to keep away from that. That'll trigger the boss event. Actually, let me save.
Yep. Yep.
Yes.
Yep.
What is this?
Yep.
I'm gonna start checking up high now. Pick on the houses.
Yep.
I'll go back here just to check. I believe I already got this one. It can hurt to double check. Well, that's just a part of the rock. Huh. I thought there was one up here. Maybe that there is. Because I don't see a chest. Or like one that we've got. An open one, so maybe. No, I don't see that. I guess you could technically say that that's like close right there. Right. On this side we have yeah, there's that one. That was just flowers.
Yep.
Where could this chest be?
Yep.
This takes too long. I'll give it probably another minute. Last chest would be. So, I do want to check up here one more time. Keep falling.
Yep.
Oof. Actually, I didn't check this. Did I? Okay, this leads to down here where we had this chest. Yeah, I don't remember what this. Or I don't. I wouldn't say remember. Because I obviously don't know where it is. I don't know what it is, where this chest is. Maybe I did get this chest in proud mode. But for whatever reason, I'm not. It's not like refreshing my memory, so and also they added those zodiac chests, so for all I know it's one of those. So other than that, thanks for watching. I'll try and keep up with this one. Right now I did have some time. I didn't want to record Resident Evil 7 because that one I'm gonna try and do like by hours, and I had like about 30 minutes free, and with Resident Evil, like I said, out an hour each episode. That's my target. Part 2 was a little short because I wanted to get to bed a little early. I had lab today and wanted to be ready for that. But other than that, yeah, it just has 99 saves. Other than that, thanks for watching. If you want to see more, subscribe and or follow my Twitter. Whenever I upload a video, I have it to where it posts, hey, this video's up or something. So if you follow me on there, you'll see the notification about if you see my tweets. Most of them will be like new video's been uploaded or something. I'm trying to be more active on there, so like when I posted last night about prod mode. But other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.